Minister Ryan, I'm glad you're here tonight for this topical issue. And this debate, Minister, I'm raising tonight, has been a long time coming. People trying to report faults when they ring, they have an average waiting time of 57 minutes. That's an average waiting time, Minister. I'm not raising this issue tonight to complain, but just I'm simply concerned. As we face into the winter and the dark nights and the I'm worried about people's mental health. I'm worried about their safety and security. Minister, it's just a shambles, an unmitigated shambles and disaster. I'm not blaming you. I differ with you in many opinions, with green issues and other, but on this issue I don't. It's a whole of government abandonment of the people of Ireland, rural and urban. I mean, people with their pendant alarms, people with their other kind of alarms connected to their telephone, people who do not use mobile phones, the elderly, the vulnerable, and they're all abandoned. If the line goes off, they're out. I salute the founders of Air and indeed Telecom Air and the telecoms. And I remember when Albert Williams waved a phone in the Fianna Fáil address one time, that every phone would be fitted in a month, and it was. Now you can't get a phone disconnected, it would take you a year. But you can't get a phone repaired, it'll take you... communications, imagine. Just imagine. This is communications. 60 minutes and you can't get through. I have a text here from a man sending me a message on Facebook this evening. Mr. McGrath, I'm a constituent of yours. I have been trying to contact AIR every day since July 20th, being on hold every day for up to 60 minutes without ever actually getting through to anyone. And this company needs to be closed down. This is shocking, Minister. In 2020, in the dark age, in the pigeons, and when we had delivered messages, would be better than this. This is outrageous. They must be taken to task and must be disbanded. As I said, salute the proud workmen that were there when they put up the lines and brought the phones and the care and attention that they had to their customers and to the dignity of their work and the respect they had. Now there's poles falling out in the road, hitting into buses or lorries, breaking mirrors. The constituent on me today, he can't cut his hedges. He's getting hedge notices from the county council to cut his hedges. He can't. Why? Because the wires are lying down on the ditch. They're lying in roads, they're lying in bogs. It's a third world service, and above all, no communications. When a constituent contacts me, they ask for all their... When they're futile efforts and they're weary of being on the phone to air for so long, they contact the office. When the office get representation, the constituent, we have to try to contact air themselves. They see us as their only last hope, and many other offices as well as mine, often to assist in getting the air system getting an email address. They don't have email. They don't do Google. They don't have broadband anyway. It's shocking and it's disgraceful treatment, and it should be brought before the European Court of Human Rights, because people are entitled to get a service that they pay for. Pay dear for connection and pay dear for rent, and they can't use it. What about the children? Nadine Yoga, going back to college, the school, the exams, online now. You're talking about the options for education. They can't get the broadband. They don't have the service. What about the farmer trying to do his application for grants? What about the CEO courses? The people of rural land especially have been discriminated, but there are urban people affected as well. So, Minister, it's time now that your government, that you're newly in, sorted out this issue and stopped the blackguarding and the plunder and rape of a good community by this company, so-called AIR. They should be ashamed of their name. They should be ashamed of it because they don't represent anything anymore. To think that, I had a gentleman recently, they have 6 months trying to get disconnected from AIR. 6 months trying to get disconnected. I had another man contacted me tonight, Paul Laffert from CARE, who had an ordeal and a half to try and deal with AIR, who accused him of not paying his bills. And when he didn't produce his bank statements, they had to, didn't apologise, but they had to accept that he had paid them. And apparently they didn't do it. So we have comrades. They might be toothless, useless and fruitless. We have many more comrades out there on boards that do nothing for the public. They just have nice fancy names, fancy jobs, and to hell with the people of Ireland. It's a sad indictment in 2020 that that's been allowed to continue, and I appeal to your minister to use your good office within the whole of government to deal with this shambolic, disgraceful company.
Thank you very much indeed, Garlick, and thank you very much, Deputy McGrath, for raising what is a very important issue. As he knows, the provision of electronic communication services, including the repair and restoration of telephone services, occurs within a liberalised market, regulated by the independent regulator ComReg, which, as he refers to himself, it is responsible for the regulation of electronic communication sector under European and national legislation. I recognise, as he says, how vital telecommunications services are for citizens, for so many aspects of their daily lives, especially during the current COVID pandemic. Both I and the officials from our department are very focused on the need to ensure that telecommunication customers are sympathetically treated at this very challenging time. In this regard, officials from our department have been engaging intensively with ComRAG and with the industry during this period. Since COVID began, ComRAG have been monitoring consumer issues, reporting to us regarding outages, and particularly those outages for vulnerable customers that may need to be escalated. ComRAG advises customers experience difficulties to contact a service provider in the first instance. Following this, the customer is advised to contact themselves, ComRAG, and depending on the particular circumstances, the issues may be escalated by ComRAG. One of ComRAG's functions is to determine the scope of the universal service obligations for the Irish market and decides which undertaking should be designated as the universal service provider. The universal service obligation is designed to assure that every person who makes a responsible request for access for a connection and a phone service at a fixed location can have access to a basic set of telecommunication services, no matter where they live. On the 29th of July 2016, ComRAG designated AIR as the universal service provider until June 2021. That designation as the universal service provider of basic telecommunication services includes a requirement, amongst others, to clear line faults within timelines set in the universal service obligation. As the designated universal service provider, AIR is also required to publish information on the performance in relation to the provision of the universal service obligation, which ComRAG publishes on a quarterly basis. Legally binding annual quality of service performance targets for AIR are also set by ComRAG as the independent regulator for telecommunications operators in respect of connections and serviceability targets at a national level. AIR provides a customer guarantee scheme also in relation to repairs. It provides 2 months telephone exchange line rental credit where faults are not repaired within 2 working days from the date the fault was reported to AIRCOM. Any complaint that AIR is failing to provide such a basic services or failing to restore lines within a reasonable period should be forwarded to ComRAG for further examination. I must reiterate that ensuring the performance by AIR of the requirements of this universal service obligation is a statutory function of ComRAG, and therefore as Minister have no role or function in the issue. ComRAG is directly accountable for the performance of its functions to a committee of one or both of the Houses as provided in Section 34 of the Communications Regulation Act 2002. It has a dedicated consumer helpline, and I would urge consumers to feel that they've not received an appropriate response from service providers to make contact with the regulator. But Deputy, I will also, because you've raised the issue here, I will make sure that your question and the concerns you've raised are raised directly with ComRAG, make sure they're aware of the debate we have tonight, because it is, as you say, deeply frustrating and deeply annoying. Anyone who's been left on a phone for 60 minutes, as you say, waiting for an operator or a customer service operation to answer, particularly one in telecommunications, which isn't able to answer the phone after an hour, is maddening for customers. And I know this is an issue that drives a lot of people mad, that the basic services you would expect of a quick response and contact not being provided is, as you say, a matter of real concern. And I will make sure that this debate and the details of it are forwarded on to ComRAG.
Good Minister, look, I have written to Caroline Lennon, CEO of AIR. We might as well be writing to Santa Claus. They have no respect for the customers. I again pay tribute to the workers. And Paddy O'Kelly, a good friend of my neighbour of mine, who retired recently after 42 odd years, and his colleagues, who are travelling around the country now in vans, they're travelling 100 miles or more to try to do repairs. They don't have the staff on the ground. They don't have the interest. Your Minister read out that reply. You're a decent man, and I know that. And I thank you for agreeing to come to Tipperary and show you some of the conditions of the network when you are coming to Tipperary, because it's the land of your forebears as well. I thank you for that. But Minister, that reply you read out there is patronising, it's insulting, and it's toilet paper. It's disgraceful. You said an hour to wait for a call. They can't get them for months. They ring every day for months, they don't get them. And they don't get called back. You can't get your line disconnected. You can't get them to get a phone put in. So people are flocking away from them, and this company is faltering, and it's about to fail, and it will fail. Then you give them the they have the issue of AIR broadband. I have people living 50 yards away from where it stops. I have people living 100 yards away, and they can't get it. Sick people. People who want appointments. We have a service in South Tipperary, our small village of Newcastle. Good morning, South Tipperary. Tipperary listening service. We have wonderful volunteers who come in there every Monday and ring elderly and vulnerable and lonely people. Alone have come on board and I salute them as well. But sure, the people having phone lines, we can't get them and they can't make a complaint. And they don't, as I said, have computers. They're not able to do that kind of stuff. So they're being blackguarded. Our elderly people who looked after this country, who built it up. And that's the way they're being blackguarded. I might say business people and farmers and young people. So it's a shame. To see the network now would make you sad to see the light wires and the poles leaning into the fields out on the road, and they're rotten and they're dangerous. And I was in the council yard yesterday morning where several men had to come in from here, our private contractor, looking for signs to attend to the road job, to get a pole that was hanging over the road, a danger to the public, fixed. It's a dad's army job. It's crazy stuff. And if you don't do something about this, more shame on you and the government that they're going to abandon the citizens, especially this time of COVID, when loneliness and isolation, and the only contact they have is that ever go on and that phone in their hand, and to have the chat and the kind with their friends. It's a shame. They're prisoners of their own house and they have no communication with the outside world. So, Minister, it's time now on you, and I'm depending on you, because this has been raised here several times. It's just got worse and worse, and they have no interest in serving the public. All they want is the lula and the money and to help with the people. And Comrade should be disbanded with them, because, as I said, they're useless, toothless and fruitless. They have jobs for the boys, that's all they have, and they'll tell you that they'll talk to them. A waste of time. Go on,
thank you very much indeed, Deputy McGrath. Where there's a shortage of service, where there's actually an inability for customers, particularly in rural areas, to get broadband, I hope the new national broadband scheme, which we are ruling out, I'm going to be asking questions about that later on, will actually close that gap. We'll make sure that there isn't a single house left out. And it may also have knock-on benefits in terms of the building up of the pole network and other infrastructure network to serve that, will hopefully benefit and help other customers as the backhaul and other parts of the network are enhanced to provide that coverage. And where that isn't possible, or in other parts where there is competition, where there is rival services, where the likes of Ciro, which is rolling out in tens of thousands of houses now, high-quality broadband, that is one of the ways to make sure that other operators, if they're not providing the sort of customer service we expect, that there are consequences, that customers will move, use their power to move to other operators where they are getting a proper service, where they are getting a proper response, where they are getting... Well, as I said, but that is in areas where there isn't a service, we will step in to close the gap. And where there is competition, I believe that will be a huge impetus for the companies. But at the same time, as was in my original response, there is a universal service obligation on air. It is Comreg's job to monitor and manage and where appropriately reprimand companies if they're not meeting the basic service requirements set out in that. And I will certainly forward your complaints to them to get the message across, as you say, that what you are seeing on the ground in Tipperary is not up to what is expected of a universal service provider. I will certainly make sure that is brought to their attention, and I presume that they will. It's then their responsibility to take whatever action they have to take.